Hello, YouTube. I want to tell you that I'm very honored to speak before you and that Jesus Christ is using me to talk to you, and that I believe that the Holy Spirit sent you to receive this message. First things first, I do believe that Jesus Christ is Lord. I do believe that He is my Savior. He is the Savior. I believe He is fully man, fully God. I believe that Jesus Christ is come, not has come, but is come. He came and is still here, establishing His kingdom in the flesh. Me, you. We are the kingdom of God. It is not I who live, but Christ lives in me. I am the temple of God. So, I've been on YouTube for quite a while, and this is my first upload ever. The reason why I feel strongly about this is because I am watching the other watchers on the wall, which I thank you. You're getting out some great information. YouTube has helped to wake me up, wake my family up to the occult, to Bohemian Grove, Illuminati, New World Order, all that stuff. But I believe and I feel that God is causing me to rely on Him more in preparation for what is to come. Not, do I have enough gold? Do I have enough silver? And it is wise to prepare. A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, but the simple pass on and are punished. Proverbs 6:6-8, go to the ant, thou sluggard, consider her ways and be wise, which having no guide, overseer, or ruler, provideth her meat in the summer and gathered her food in the harvest. I believe it's wisdom. I mean, study history and whatnot. It's wisdom to want to provide for your family. Food, water, gold, silver, whatnot. I want to take a step further, though. If your faith that you believe these things will save you when the crap hits a fan can be further from the truth. Let's be honest with ourselves. I've thought about this many times, and I really didn't want to think about it. So I'm going to put it in front of you that we have to think about this, and I believe I have the answer. Let's say you have 3 months, food, water, ammo. I mean, you're stocked. You're good to go. You have a plan. Your family has a plan. You and yours are good. What about your in-laws? What about your friends? What about your neighbors? You can survive whatever you think is going to come down the pike, right? Your ear is against the railroad. You know every angle. What's the end game for you to survive? The end game is to love your neighbor as yourself. And if you give a cup of water to the least of these, you will have your reward in heaven. So are you going to see your friends and family die? Are you going to lock them out and not give them any food or water? Are you going to let them be taken away to FEMA camps because we tried to wake them up? And let's take where to go. Where do we go? There's going to be historical earthquakes. There's going to be volcanoes that we never knew of. There's going to be asteroids hitting the earth. There's going to be plagues. There's going to be all sorts of garbage if we are here, right? So where do you go? Underneath the frost line, all this stuff is foolishness. It's foolish. There's no way to prepare for this stuff. So what's the answer? Well, we're Christians. The same Holy Spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead now lives in us. Jesus Christ, the Son of God, says He does not do anything if He does not see the Father in heaven do it first. So He was in constant communion with His Father. He was holy. He was a perfect conduit for what the Father wanted to do. And that's what we need to be working on now. This is the season, folks. Across the board, Christians and people, New Agers, whoever, everybody knows that something's coming down the pike, and it's big. And anxiety, fear, anger, all those emotions are rampant. But the emotion we need to be having is peace. Peace that passes all understanding. Isaiah 53:5, God paid for our peace. He paid for our diseases. He paid for our sins. But He paid for our peace. But He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon Him, and with His stripes we are healed. If you guys read Fox Book of Martyrs, those guys are getting boiled and filleted and staked and drowned. And peace, man. These guys were preaching during being burnt. They were being supernaturally saved. you know, before they were, you know, drowned. I mean, I love the stories, you know, threw a huge rock around the sky, threw him in the river to drown him. And he floated for an hour, preached to everybody on the bank. And then when he was done, God, take me away. Then he drowned. Same thing with fire. And I mean, look at the Bible. Look at the supernatural things that happen. To John, you know, they had to exile him because they tried to boil him and it didn't work. So supernatural things are coming down the pike, but how do we tap into these things? It's by faith. Without faith, you can't please God. And what is faith? Faith is a conviction of beliefs. So if you feel like the Bible is not the word of God, then how can you have faith? Because faith comes by the hearing of the word of God. You read something like a little kid, you don't filter it through your experience, and you read it like a little kid, and you apply it. You're convicted that if it's in the Bible, it is God's word and it's true. That's how you expound your faith. So I think it's wisdom to have gold, silver, ammo, food, but you're not going to have enough for more than 3 months, most likely. You're not going to have enough for your neighborhood, for your friends and family who haven't woken up and are just now they're scared. What are you going to do? Are you going to shoot everybody who comes at you? There's some uncomfortable verses, like don't resist an evil person. And I'm sure some of you say that's put in there by the Illuminati to submit, but I mean, look at Jesus Christ. He did not resist. You know, even before his time, they picked up stones to stone him. And what does the Bible say? He passed right through them. It wasn't his time. Supernaturally, Jesus is our strong tower. What about money? You know, Pharisees came to him and said, you know, who do you pay taxes to? And the end result of that is told one of his disciples, go pitch a line in the river. First fish you pull out, look in his mouth. He's got a coin enough to pay for the fisher's tax and Jesus' tax. Look at food. Look at the Israelites. Manna from heaven, the bread from heaven. Angels' food. Right? Took care of them night and day. Elijah fed by the ravens. You know, Jesus Christ cursed a fig tree. The day later, it was dried up from the roots. What if he blessed that fig tree? The day later, he would have 100-fold of crops. Some other supernatural events that I want to bring to your attention is if you forget your water filter, you can always speak to a rock like Moses did. Don't forget that Jesus Christ fed 5,000 and then later 4,000 people with just a few loaves and fishes. Also the Israelites, they listened, they obeyed, they applied the blood of the lamb, spotless blood of the lamb on the doorposts, and the angel of death passed over them. It's faith, folks. It's faith that's going to save us. Faith in Jesus Christ. We are going to be persecuted. We're going to unto death. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now has come salvation and strength in the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our God day and night. And they overcame him, Satan, by AK-47s and AR-15s. No, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And they loved not their lives unto the death. We all know that this is a spiritual battle. In fact, most of you are the ones that bring me to and show me that it's the occult that's behind this. The Bohemian Girl, they serve Molech. They offer sacrifices, fake or real. You know, these guys are evil. So in one voice, you're saying that, but then the next voice, you're saying, you know, let's gear up on ammo. And unless you have a gun that shoots demons, then, you know, if you do, like, give me the website because I like one. That'd be helpful. But we don't, and our battle is not against flesh and blood, right? So how can we combat this? Well, first, we have to be out of the world, right? Which it means that we can't look like the world. We can't be sinning and, hey, Jesus loves you when you have a stash of pornography underneath your bed. How powerful do you think you're going to be? How impactful are you going to be for the kingdom when you have all these secret sins? Folks, this is the season to clean up. I mean, enough warnings, right? Enough warnings. It's time to clean up. And if you can't say no to your flesh, then try a fast. You know, say no to food and water. That will help you say no to the flesh once you come out of that fast.
He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him, and will manifest myself to him.
I was working on a home in the dream, and I asked the wife to get a ladder, and she didn't want to do it, so we're kind of arguing. And so I came down to go get the ladder, and I walked into a spider web, kind of frustrating. Anyways, after I pull off the spider web, I look around to where I was working. I look back, and this spider had built, like within seconds, supernaturally, the spider built a wall of web from the top of my roof all the way down to the ground. And it covered half my home all the way to the next, to the neighbor's home. And while I'm just in awe, showing the wife, like, man, this thing had, it wasn't there 2 seconds ago. This is totally supernatural, praising God. And then right then, volcanic ash starts falling, starts covering the car, starts, and I look over and the spider web is catching all of this ash. And I can sense that based on my work and the spider web basically finished my work. I believe it was covering up, you know, an important part of my home, you know, ventilation system, whatever. And so we go inside to escape the ash. We go lock the door, and there's these two huge birds. In the dream, I thought they were turkeys, but then after I woke up, they were emus. Two huge birds trying to get inside my home, and I'm like kicking them out, you know, trying to shut the door. And I can hear the God, and I can hear my Lord say, "That's your food." And so it's kind of like, "That's your food, dummy." And so anyways, open the door, let them in, and then we start discussing on how do we prepare the birds for our food. And so I woke up. That was pretty much the end of the dream. I don't believe that this is, I didn't feel like this is a prophetic dream that this is going to happen, but it was a confirmation to me that God will supernaturally provide. Again, Elijah being fed by the ravens. Look at the Israelites, the 10 plagues, right? 10 horrible, nasty plagues happening in the Israelites' backyard. They're living in Goshen. and, you know, the Bible says, you know, it really doesn't say that the Israelites were not affected up until the darkness plague. And it says that darkness fell on the land for 3 days, but the Israelites had light in their dwellings. And then, of course, if they weren't obedient to the next commandment for Passover, then their firstborn would have been killed. So they listened, they obeyed, and they were saved. There's a fellow on here that I had a conversation with, and I asked him if God was moving him towards the same idea that we need to be more and more reliant on the Holy Spirit and to increase our faith for survival. And I believe his end point was God helps those who helps themselves. And that really bothered me because, first of all, it's not biblical at all. In fact, the more I thought about it, the more demonic it sounds, because while we're yet sinners, Christ died for us. So how did you help yourself before Christ died for you? You didn't. And Romans 9, it's not those who willeth or those who runneth, but it's God who gives mercy. Look at the Israelites. How did they prepare? How did they help themselves during that 400 years to get out of Israel? They didn't. What they did was they repented, and God heard them and had mercy on them. Great verse. Elijah, right? Israel hates you. Israel has taken down the altars, has destroyed all your prophets. I'm the only one left. Help me. Like, where do I go? Like, Israel has turned against you and is wanting my life. God said, I have spared 7,000 men who have not bowed or kissed Baal. I mean, what a great verse, right? God knows your heart. God knows, are you serving the prince of this world? Are you kissing the prince of this world? Or are you living holy? Are you obeying God? Are you spreading his message? Are you keeping short accounts? When's the last time you forgave somebody, you know? Man, forgiveness is huge, folks. Gotta forgive. Matthew 18, man. If you don't forgive, God will give you over to tormentors. It's about faith, guys. It's about faith. And this is a season to get the ship upright. Start reading the Bible. Start believing the Bible, not your experiences, all right? If the Bible says it happened, and you can do it. Miracles wasn't for the disciples in Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ lives in you. The same Holy Spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead now lives in you. So don't change your theology or philosophy so you can explain away the scriptures. Have the scriptures change you and have you aspire to these things. Have them, Lord, why can I raise anybody from the dead? Why can I heal anybody? Why aren't ravens feeding me? Why isn't there water coming from a rock when I need it? Ask the Lord. These things have to happen for you to survive. There's no way you can store up enough for everyone. Unless you just go around killing everybody that has and you take from them. And yeah, it's great you survived, but probably going to hell. So, and you're sending other people to hell too. So it's insane. It's a tough subject. It's a very tough subject. Thanks for listening. Like I said, if you're here, then please test everything I say. Test everything I say. Holy Spirit, ask the Holy Spirit, go to the scriptures. Am I right? Am I wrong? Do you have enough gold and silver to... Do you have enough food? Do you have enough water? The answer is no. It's your strong tower. You will overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. If you don't know what this means, this is what you need to dive into. Not what the occult is doing right now. How the police are brutalizing Occupy Wall Street right now. Your goal right now is to get as close to God and holy as you can. That is how we will overcome them. God bless. I love you. I'm truly honored. Thanks again.